Previously on Republic of Doyle.
Sign.
If I sign, do I get those pictures?
I'm keeping them, so you'll stay the hell away from me and my family.
We're not that different, you and me. You realize if circumstances were somehow different, you and me might even have been good friends.
There he is. Maliki, how's it hanging?
You should see the look on your face.
How do I look?
Really scared.
Everything all right?
I wanted to straighten things out with us.
Sounds pretty complicated.
Not with me.
So you want to make out again?
You tell anybody about that and I will kill you.
Not only did you ruin a deposition for me professionally, but you left me standing half naked in your apartment.
When you're in love and it's not working out, it can make you kind of foggy.
Ow! Gee, God, I think you're making it worse.
Sorry, Eli.
That pullout is killing me.
Well, you know, I wanted to put a bed in here, but the old man thinks it'll send the wrong signal to the clients.
Well, JK, maybe a big boy apartment's in order. I don't know. Maybe your own house.
All due respect, Allison, please just, you know, mind your own business with all that.
Fine.
Oh, no, don't. Look, I just... Everyone in my life is constantly giving me crap, and I'd really, really appreciate it if you weren't one of those people. That's all I'm saying.
I'm not giving you crap.
You are, kind of.
I'm tired, okay, because I haven't slept. Jake, come on.
What? Now, how was that my fault? Look, I have an iron somewhere. Well, actually, I don't own
it. Forget it, okay? I will see you later, or, I don't know, whenever.
Whatever.
That was lovely. I really enjoyed breakfast today. Thank you very much, Rose. Really appreciate it. Thanks, Mel.
You made it while we were sleeping.
For old time's sake, just wanted to surprise you.
Oh, you certainly did that. I gotta work, so maybe you want to,
You want me to leave?
Yeah.
I just gotta meet Jake downtown. Big case.
Well, I'm totally free today. It's weird. No case, no work, no nothing. Is he holding you hostage or something?
By the way, congratulations on the recent nuptials. I heard all about it. I want to wish you both all the happiness.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
But it's a little early in the morning for the tree to be drinking, don't you think?
Well, Martin surprised us, made us breakfast.
I got a confession to make. I actually do have an ulterior motive.
Get out.
I do.
No, I mean get out.
I got a business opportunity for you. You don't want to hear it or not?
Business?
Yeah. Pretty good business opportunity, too. Could make us all rich. Trust me.
Sounds great. No.
You might want to leave. You don't want to make him mad.
But in my experience, 300 grand can calm anybody down.
Whoa. Wait now.
Well.
$300,000? Just let the man talk.
Here's me without my pitch notes.
Jake, what are you doing?
Just, can't you hear the man talking?
I got a picture of a woman called Tony Burke. She's an accountant. She handles all these real hotshot clients. And what she did was she's embezzled millions, and now there's a massive reward out there for her.
Let me guess. She just happens to be in town right now.
You should do this for a living. Yes, she's here for the next 12 hours only.
Do we look like bounty hunters?
$300,000 and you can look like what you want to look like.
Oh, Martin.
Now, come on. I just want a little adventure. Plus, I can use your help on this. What do you say?
Okay, who did she rob the money from?
Her employers, I guess. The point is that she's here, she's up for grabs. If we make a move right now, we can capitalize on it. What do you say?
Absolutely not.
Now, just give us a sec. You know, maybe he's telling the truth. I, for one, actually kind of believe him. You should have more faith in people.
You got me thrown in jail last year.
Jake, nothing is ever as it seems with him.
Look, I'm a big boy. I know I can handle him. You guys don't want to do this? I'll do it myself. Yeah, you can't be all bad.
Okay, so we're good then? Partners?
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Okay, but I'm watching you. And Jake, I hope you know what you're doing.
So do I.
Partner. Managed to skim a cool $3 million off the books from who she was working for. So 10% of the finder's fee, $300K. That's what we're after. She's at the airport, leaving for Mexico. So it's called 11 hours.
So we just sit and wait for her at the airport?
No. Anyone could just snatch her. There's 300 grand on the line. We gotta move now.
Like how you think.
The reward is legit. It's on the Fed's website. They've been looking for her for almost a year, but they're not saying why.
Top secret stuff, embezzlement.
This Tony, she doesn't look much like a crook to me or an accountant.
Well, you better look than whoever does your taxes.
I do her taxes.
I stand corrected.
Mm-hmm.
She's traveling with her sister. Sister's name is Siobhan McDonough. I got a picture of her.
Well, she appears to be a ghost. She's not on any hotel registries or anywhere else in the city.
She's a gambler, total degenerate.
How do you know all this?
Well, I've been working all the angles on this case before I brought it to you. I wanted to make sure it was 100% legit.
And you can ID this the sister, Siobhan?
Absolutely.
Did you color your hair?
Yeah. How do I look?
Very handsome.
Hey, thank you.
Then what's your plan?
I've got a plan. You guys are the private detectives. I'm just bringing it to you. The only I can offer is I have a certain, you know, feeling for the law.
And from the wrong side of it, you mean?
Well, no need to be judgmental about it. It does give you a certain insight. Gotta admit that.
You want to work with us? You do what we say all the time, and we'll get along fine.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, and if we find out that you're messing with us?
I wouldn't dream of it, okay? I want to do it your way. It's my hand to God. Can I put my picture up? Okay.
All right. If Tony's in town, we just got to paper her picture around, show it to some friends. I mean, if she's in the city, she can't be that hard to track.
We apprehend her, turn her over to the local guys for the reward. Simple.
So the mystery gal, Siobhan, you say she's a gambler?
Oh, she likes craps. Loves craps. It's the only game she plays.
It's a bit early, but...
There's only one guy who'd be running the game at this time of day.
All right, listen, I gotta go do something. I won't be long, I promise. You gonna be okay with your new BFF, the handsome ex-con?
I think I liked him better when he's trying to steal my wife.
Standing right here, guys.
I'll see you.
You give?
Nobody.
Good. You asked for it, and I'm bringing it.
Oh, I can take it. I can take it. See, that's what I'm talking about. See, Jake will never take me seriously until he understands my physical prowess.
You're not exactly a cage fighter.
True, I suffer from discoordination. And, well, fear. But I can get past it.
We'll whip you into shape.
Okay, all right. You ready? You ready? Here we go. I think I smell toast. I definitely smell toast. Okay, all right. Okay, a B.I.'s gotta be badass, right? So you gotta be able to take a punch as well as throw one.
At this rate, you'll take plenty. You can't half-ass this kind of thing, or Jake will never see you as more than a little brother.
Little brother, really? Did he say that? Wait. Yeah, I'm not like a sibling to you, am I?
What are you talking about? No. Why?
No reason. Oh. You like that? You like that? I got you.
Nice one. Too slow, Courtney.
Hey, Allison, it's me. I just thought I might run into you at the coffee shop or whatever.
Hey.
About this morning.
Mr. Doyle, hey there. Hey.
I'll call you later, okay?
Are you, you know, some kind of big stakeout here, or?
No, not really.
Look, I've been meaning to talk with you. I'll meet you back at the office, okay? Thanks. How are you, Mr. Doyle?
Best kind.
I'm so glad I ran into you. You were an officer, right? The RNC?
A long time ago, yeah.
You mind if I ask what happened there?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you miss it?
Do I miss taking orders and wearing funny little hats? No.
No, do you miss the pension, the dental plan?
Well, luckily, all of my teeth have already been knocked out and replaced, so...
Can I speak off the record here? We are thinking of creating a kind of a particular task force, you know? It's a changing city and need to make moves to protect her. And I think a guy like you, with your talents, would be a great asset for the team. Are you interested?
Are you offering me a job?
No, just talking, just asking. Don't answer. I just want you to just think about it, okay? Nice talking to you.
You know what we could do? Let's pretend we're cops, watch for them, and start bashing heads. We gotta do something for them.
You wanna go into an illegal casino at 10 in the morning and pretend we're cops?
No. We're standing around here doing nothing. What are we doing here, bird watching?
No. First, we assess the situation. Then we come up with a plan of attack.
Measure twice, cut once. Once a cop, always a cop.
What kind of a lowlife goes into a casino at 10 in the morning?
Should hit the ATM. I got rolling ammo.
Any sign of him?
We're waiting for you.
Huh.
Got some irons in the fire here? What's going on, kid?
Finn?
$50 buy-in, fellas.
Yeah, look, we're looking for two sisters, all right? Did two girls show up here this morning?
Well, our customers appreciate their privacy, you know. I mean, this could jeopardize my livelihood. I got people to support.
Finn, you live alone, you know, except for your cat.
Maybe this will help your dependents.
Okay, inside, craps table. Now, boys, don't go making a racket. It's no job for me, right? So, you know, I'll be discreet.
All right, no problem. Thank you.
Still a $50 minimum buy-in, Jake. Boss, you know, rules is rules.
I'm not playing with my money.
I got you, Finn.
Enjoy your game, boss. Keep her clean.
Thanks, Finn. Bye.
She's the blonde right there. See her?
Hey, listen, do me a favor. 150 and 15. Bye.
What?
What the hell is this?
A taser?
Yeah. Well, it's not for Tony. It's for the bounty hunter.
The what? The bounty hunter?
You said she was the sister.
No. Bounty hunter.
You found me.
Let her go, Siobhan. Let her go. She's coming with me.
Go home, old man. This is my retirement plan.
Well, I'm sorry to have to tell you, but I'm going to rob your little nest egg.
Whoa, whoa, what are you doing? Whoa.
You. Take a breath, boys.
Martin?
Wrist's on the table.
I don't know who you're dealing with here, but she's mine.
I'm taking her, with or without your arm.
I found her once. It'll be even easier to track down the two.
I won't be hiding.
You want to tell us what you're not telling us here?
Back up. You. Drop the taser. Cut her loose.
Why me?
Shut up and do it.
All right. Wish me luck, all right?
Hand it over.
Please.
Jake, we gotta stop them.
Police, everybody's hands behind their heads.
Every time Martin Poole comes to town, I end up in jail.
This is just great.
Are you okay? What are you doing here?
It's nice to, you know, run into you like this in the middle of a workday.
I'm not joking. What are you involved in exactly?
I'm working on a case. What do you want me to say?
What do I want you to say? Well, I don't know. You're in jail.
It happens. Big deal.
Whatever the case with the accountant, drop it.
Sorry, what was that?
Tony Burke is bigger than you, Jake. Just do us both a favor and do as I say. Drop it.
Do as I say? Am I hearing you right?
You know what? I don't have time for this. I shouldn't even be in here. You know, I'm just going to pretend that you are some low-life degenerate who got picked up gambling in some low-life casino.
Well, whatever turns you on.
You know what would turn me on is if you grew up. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to give you crap. I can't talk to you about this case, Jake. It's huge. I just need you to stay out of it.
Miss Jenkins?
Sergeant. Mr. Doyle.
What?
We're not pressing charges. You're free to go.
Thank you very much.
We're not feeding you, if that's what you think.
Girlfriend, she pissed?
Leslie?
I was referring to the lawyer, Allison.
Oh, yeah, I was, yeah.
He must be sitting on something big. We can't trust a word Martin says anyway.
Yeah, I tell you, I was really looking forward to that payday.
My gut's telling me to walk away.
Martin, I can't talk to you, all right? So this is goodbye.
No. Okay, look, you gotta get here. I got trouble.
He's got trouble. You got trouble? We were in jail, all right? And some guy with an axe almost took our head off. Plus, he had a friggin' machine gun, for God's sake.
Look, there's been a couple of unforeseen bumps in the road. I'll give you that one, okay? But look, if you ever want to see your pretty little blue car again, you'll get yourself down here.
Whoa, what'd you say?
I'm here at Lou's Automotive or something like that on the Logie Bay Road. Does that ring a bell?
Logie Bay Road. It's Logie Bay Road. What do you mean you got my car? You son... I have to go get a cab.
Thanks a lot. Hey, do you want to know your
time of death, or will I?
Relax. Keys are in the ignition. Everything's fine. Not a scratch on it.
Look, how many times did I have to tell you? We do this my way or not, not at all. What the hell is that?
Plan kind of changed, so.
What is wrong with you?
Watch my back.
Have you lost your mind? Just get a hold of yourself, all right?
Hey!
Get out of here! The girl comes with me! You're a dead man!
Well, I got a feeling that your firearms are in this vehicle over here. Otherwise, you'd be shooting back by now, am I right? Get out of here. Go get yourself some fish and chips or boiled cabbage or something.
Run! You know what? You're a bigger, bigger idiot than I thought you were.
Oh, God.
Oh, I need you to find me.
Oh, Jake Doyle. Why don't you meet Tony Burke? My wife. Show me the ring, honey.
Okay, the cops are going to be looking for you everywhere.
And they're going to connect us to it, for sure.
The important thing is that I got what I wanted. You're going to get your money, because not from a bounty, I guess, but we're going to pay out of our own pocket. Can everybody just relax here?
Martin, why weren't you just straight with us from the start?
Well, I wanted to be. I just thought, you know, I didn't want emotions to come into play here. And, of course, I wanted to spare Rosie's feelings. And
why would you have to spare her feelings?
I'm just joking. I barely know the woman. You don't get it. Oh, forget it. Just relax.
I'm done with this. Call the cops.
No, please, I can't go to jail.
That guy back there, he was sent by the bikers. Tony here used to be their accountant.
I stole $3 million. If I go to jail, I'm dead. If I testify, I'll be dead before the trial.
No, this just keeps getting better and better.
Of course, the cops want her to testify because she can supply details of the inner workings of the whole organization. You get it.
The bikers can find me anywhere. It means we have to keep on the move.
Oh, yeah, we gotta keep on the move.
Why would you want to spare her feelings?
Okay, we used to be married, okay?
Oh, boy.
Long time ago.
You were married to her?
Yeah.
It's okay, honey.
Don't be like that.
How long? How long were you married to her?
20 years, give or take.
What?
What about this? No, you're the one that I love. I told you that already. I meant it.
Shut up.
Relax. There's people here. If you get us out of Dodge, I swear to God, I'll pay you the 300 grand as soon as we get the cash.
As soon as you get it? What do you mean? She stole $3 million from the bikers.
Offshore. What do you think? She smuggled out in her purse every night from the clubhouse? We spent everything we had hiding her out here.
Fine, whatever. We're going to drop you off at a bus station, understand?
We don't want your money. Just want your word that you walk away and never come back.
Here.
Either way, the cops are probably waiting for you downstairs right now. So I have a plan. We have to split up.
Split up?
We can talk about the whole money thing after, you know, when Dad's not around.
Tez Courtney, Jr. P.I., Doyle and Doyle Investigations.
Whatever, just shut up. All right, I need you and Tinny to get down here right away.
No problem, bro. Whatever you need, I got your back, bro.
Why do you keep calling me bro? What is wrong with you? You sound like an idiot.
You got it. Whatever you need, no matter how grueling. And Jake? Jake.
Settle.
Brothers always understand each other.
It's gonna take more than just words, Dez.
Okay, come with me and bring the painkillers.
Second, Jake. I told you to stay out of this.
Hi. How you doing?
Ma'am, take off your coat. Ma'am.
Migraine. The light aggravates it like crazy.
What did you do?
Me? I didn't do anything.
If you're lying, Jake, I swear to God.
What are we doing here, Mr. Poole?
We gotta get them to the bus station. We might take some muscle.
I'm trying to find that weird little guy that runs this place. He still owes Tony here like 800 bucks. We're going to Montreal. We need some cash.
I thought you had $3 million.
Well, not on me, sweetheart.
Yeah, but this is in and out, right?
Yeah,
because Jake trusted me to get you to the bus station.
Of course. As soon as we get the cash.
Oh, crap.
Tony, this is not happening.
Yes, it is.
Ma'am? I'm gonna have to insist that you drop the taser.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. No! Don't tell Jake!
Why don't I just save you some batteries and get down?
Probably in your best interest. Let's go.
Des, did you get him to the bus station in time?
She took Tony. She had a taser. There was nothing we could do. Des tried.
Oh, my God, Tinny. I'm so sorry. I should have never got you involved in all this. Are you all right?
I'm fine. They're a little spun, but on the way out, Tony dropped a napkin from the Highland Hotel.
Okay. Great. Good work.
Listen, take Des with you. He did good. Like, he did terrible, but he was trying. Give him a chance.
What are you talking about? Are you going soft to me?
No. Come on, Jake. He looks up to you.
All right, fine. Whatever. I'll take Des. You just tell him to meet me there and stay out of my way or whatever.
Okay.
Ew.
Hey, you. Hey.
How do you have time to be down here? Don't you got a city to run?
Yeah. No, I was just looking into something here.
What's this?
Oh, you know, I was just checking reference.
Jake Doyle, what are you? You're hiring a PI to spy on me?
No, not quite.
Is he, Bill, is he bothering you? Is he causing you trouble?
I'd rather not talk about it, honestly. Yeah, it's awkward, but let's just say it's above your pay grade.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, is this one of the complications of you and me, you know? This stuff, you can't take it personally.
I get it. I don't. I wouldn't.
Great. Well, I'll see you later, and
I'll see you.
Tip.
Bye.
Highland Hotel, you found the place. Was there a lot of traffic? Did you have trouble finding it?
Yeah.
Jake, why is the mayor putting reference checks on you?
What the hell are you talking about?
Look, don't lie to me.
Leslie, why would I lie to you?
Are you messing in my life here? Are you messing with him?
Why would I be messing in your life?
Jake, I know there's something between us. I know that, but you gotta let me get on with my life. Okay, Bill is good to me. Would you please don't mess with this?
Leslie, I am not messing with anything. He, I think maybe he offered me a job or whatever. Maybe that's it.
A job?
Yeah. And look, trust me, you made yourself very clear you don't want anything to do with me. That's fine. So, have a nice life.
Hey, is that the bounty hunter's car? Pretty good PI work, huh? I mean, not to take anything away from you. I think you're really good at your job.
I am not in the mood.
Okay, shutting up right now. So the taser's not so bad, hey? I mean, I'm still walking, right? I'm just a little shaken from endurance training, working out.
What is this? What are you doing here?
I just feel like we're cut from the same cloth, you know? Tough as hammers, tough as nails.
I know that you're always in my way, and you're always getting on my nerves, and you're always annoying the hell out of me.
Yeah?
But you've got to know, you don't need to be like me, okay? In fact, don't be like me. You can do much better. Just be yourself. Be Des.
Help!
You hear that? Someone is in the trunk.
Martin, is that you?
Hello?
Help!
Tony!
Martin,
just hang on.
Nighty night.
Oh yeah.
Who are you?
Tony Burke. Nice to meet you.
Where are we?
Oh, wine cellar. She locked us in here. How's your head?
It hurts. So where is the happy bounty hunter?
Siobhan? You pissed her off. She's probably at the casino. Small victories seem to spawn her addiction.
Obviously, she'll be back. So we gotta find a way out of here.
I already tried that. We're here. May as well enjoy ourselves, right?
Give me that. I meant the corkscrew.
Oh.
What the hell? It's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
I just love her so much.
Oh.
No offense.
No, gosh, no, none taken.
Are you sure?
Leave me.
Come on, Jake. Answer the phone. Come on. Can't find Jake.
Well, I hope he gets here in time.
Try not to worry.
Try not to. Well, you must be proud of that son of yours.
Yeah.
I'm very impressed with him.
You want a drop?
Oh, yeah, please.
Grand idea. I'll get it. Well, straight up. Splash of water, right?
You got an amazing woman. You're a lucky man.
She amazes me every day. You stay the hell away from her.
Hey, where's Tony?
Des?
Where's Jake?
Who gets tased twice in one day, really? Oh, it's not fair.
Baby.
You smell like burning hair.
Where's Tony?
Me and Jake, we found Tony, and then some evil taser bounty hunter lady. She's at me, and then she took off with Jake and Tony.
Oh, okay, where are they now, Des?
Oh, track them. I should have had Jake's back.
Des? Where's Jake? Come on.
I put a phone in Jake's bug.
Is this kid on drugs?
No.
I put a bug in Jake's phone a couple weeks ago in case something like this happened. It's on my laptop.
Oh, a bug on the computer.
Mal. What? Is Cake a food group?
We gotta get him looked at.
Des.
Who knows? I mean, if we weren't in this mess, maybe Martin and I, we wouldn't have never happened.
Yeah, well, there's nothing like, being chased by bikers, a bounty hunter, and law enforcement to get a marriage all spiced up.
It's not like that. He's
creepy ex-con?
No, Jake. We were made for each other. The moment we met, we were in love.
Really?
We fight like pit bulls, but... He pushes me. That's what he does. He pushes me. You know, he makes me a better person. And everyone should be as lucky as I am to have someone like him.
Yeah, well, whatever floats your bobber.
People think that they're in love, and then it actually happens to them. And it's amazing. Maybe it's happened to you.
Yeah. Maybe. I think I got it.
Woo-hoo! You know, Jake, I am really, really sorry. But how do I know you're not gonna turn me into the bikers?
Oh.
Hey, what happened? Well, the poor thing got tasered again.
Okay. Is he okay?
Yeah, I'm gonna take him to the doctor, but I think he'll be fine.
Whatever, he can't get any worse, hey?
You're kind of worried?
Worried?
Yeah.
No, I'm not.
Okay. We all love him and worry about him. It's okay. It's nothing to be embarrassed about.
Let's just get him in the car, okay?
Desmond! Come on, dear, get up.
Yes.
You're fine.
Come on,
you're fine.
Come on, honey.
That's it. Come on.
Good.
Let's get you in the car.
Okay,
that's it. There we go. You look pretty good.
Yellow.
Yeah, yellow
is a good color for you.
Oh, man, Martin. That wife of yours, she's a real doll.
Okay, where's Tony? Where did she go? Where's Tony?
Oh. Huh? She bashed me in the head and then she bailed.
That's her. She's got trust issues. We gotta find her before the bikers find her.
Yeah. And Rose took Des to the hospital. I better go pick him up.
I gotta find Tony.
I got a plan. I think. I
gotta find her.
I think it might work. It's our only option. Guys, I need a ride. I don't actually have her. But I think I can get her.
You're harboring a fugitive. Do you know what kind of trouble you're in?
I think I have a solution that will benefit both mutual parties.
Is that right?
Yes. You just have to hear me out, okay? Okay, so Tony needs to testify against the bikers, right, in Montreal. So what if we set a trap to lure out the biker dude? And then you capture him, and then you get Tony. But you gotta promise, though, that Tony and Martin, they'll be safe. And you put them in like a witness, a protection or something.
That's exactly what we've been trying to do, Jake. This is a huge case on both sides of the border, and we need her testimony and the money.
No problem. I just gotta find her before the bounty hunter finds her, and before the bikers find her. Hello.
Are you drunk?
Sort of. It was a work drinking thing. Don't be like that. Hello.
Meet me at the office.
Martin, where are you?
Do you have her? Are you there? Hey, hung up.
Did they get her?
I don't know, but you just give me an hour, and I will sort this out. Okay? Okay. I have been drinking a little bit, obviously, and I need to get a cab. Do you have any money? Serious anger issues. I don't think you're ready for a girlfriend right now.
What did I do? Look, if you want a girl, I got a number in my phone.
We can do this all day. But this, the blunt end of this is gonna break your shins.
If I knew anything, I'd tell you, I swear to God, I'm not really the strong, silent type.
Jake, would you open the door?
Shh.
I can hear you in there.
Can we just talk,
please? Don't do anything stupid. See the wrong thing in the first bullet's going in her head.
This is not really a very good time.
Look, I shouldn't have said what I said. I'm obviously a little sensitive when it comes to us, so. Are you okay? What happened to you?
Is that funny? Yeah, I should really get back to what I was doing, so.
You're not alone. Sorry.
I'm alone.
Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, this? No, I woke up and I'm an idiot. I fell over and I smacked my head.
I just wanted to tell you that I'm sorry. And I've been thinking about this for a while. And Jake, you're right.
No, I'm never right. That's just crazy talk.
I can't stop thinking about you. About us. Why are we doing this? Why are we doing this, Jake? Why are we hiding from the truth? It's stupid. Have you ever thought, what if you and me? I mean,
no. I haven't. So, go away now.
What?
Just go away. Leslie, I don't want you here. Go away. Bye. See ya.
Jake, what are you...
Look, what do you want me to say? Okay, we gave it a shot, and you kind of broke my heart, so... What's left to, debate about, right? Just like you to leave. Leave! Please!
I'm sorry. It's a mistake.
It was heavy, man. Sorry about that.
Yeah, well.
Really?
Why don't you go screw yourself?
Nice. Go right now. Find her, find Tony.
Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, I agree. I would hate to see the RNC look foolish on your watch. Yes. Well, if the Doyles find her, we'll just have to lean on them. Well, that's their problem. They need to learn that they can't mess with the respect of the RNC. Yes, well, I'll keep you posted. Yeah. You just let me worry about Jake Doyle.
Look, he's got your husband. If you want him to live, we've only got one option.
Whatever it takes.
Yeah, it's me. I've got what you're looking for. We need to make a trade.
Oh, yeah.
No one needs to get shot. The old man for the girl, like you said in the phone.
I don't want you here. I don't want her involved with this.
Would you shut up?
We got a slight change in plan here. Still do a trade, but I don't want this tool. You know what a pain in the ass he's been?
We had a deal.
I know we have a deal, but I have debts.
You want cash? Sure.
No cash, okay? I can't trust it. It's not some counterfeit crap that you're gonna hand off to me or mark bills or something. I want cocaine.
Oh, come on.
Are you out of your mind?
It's an excellent question. You're a high roller, right? You must have a couple of bricks of coke back there worth at least $100,000.
Yeah, you're gonna kill her. Don't you get how that works?
All right. Doesn't matter.
You won't live long enough to sell it.
Yeah, well, I'll wait.
Come on, Jake. Make him sing.
You better not screw this up, Maliki.
He'll get it done.
I feel like I'm at the kids' table again. Now, if I hadn't let Martin talk me into going to a casino, they'd be long gone by now.
Actually, yeah, it kind of is your fault.
What do I do?
I don't know, Des, but if you're going to earn Jake's respect, you're going to have to step it up. I'm just giving you the gears, bud. Don't worry about it so much.
Yeah, but you're right. Holy crap. Isn't that the bounty hunter lady who tasered me?
Yeah, that's her.
Man, oh, man.
Chill out.
She's going to ruin the whole sting. Okay, you wait here.
Where did you get that? Des?
I'm the kind of guy who brings a taser to a taser fight, you know?
You can't afford the brain cells if she zaps you again!
What do you want?
Do you enjoy hurting others?
What?
I'm here to say no. I've had enough, and the world has too.
What are you talking about?
Anything happens to her, I swear to God, I'll get you.
Shut up.
There you go. That'll net you $100,000. You'll never get a chance to sell it.
What is it?
It's cocaine. It's the biggest mistake you ever made. Hand over the girl.
It's been a pleasure doing business with you. I mean, except for the part where you were, beating the crap out of me.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Absolutely. In 3, 2, 1. Oh, would have been awesome if that had worked.
That was great. Beautifully. I knew it. I knew he was pulling something here.
Anything else on here? We got a set of bracelets here.
I knew you had a play on there. Did you see how he backed it up?
Yeah, you were a real pro.
How are you? This wife's just so bad. Yeah, you want to shoot? Go ahead.
Leslie, don't shoot.
Hold fire.
All right, I got a way out of this. It's going to be fine.
Put the gun down, Martin.
Right, anybody follows me, and I'll stick one right in his dumbass head. You got that? Let your little buddies know, too. Hey, you're driving. Hey, just take it easy.
Sorry about the cheap theatrics, but I really had to make it look real.
Yeah, well, you could have just asked me for a ride. Plus, there's no bullets in the gun.
Why would you take a gun like this to the OK Corral with no bullets in it?
I don't like bullets. Or guns, really.
But for me and Tony, this is it, Jake. This is our one last chance. Now, your gag worked pretty good with the coke there. You drew the guy out. Now, your cop girlfriend there. If she can't flip this guy, nobody can, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that.
Yeah, so we're cool.
Cops don't need me anymore.
We are cool.
Sorry about the wine bottle. Couldn't be sure.
Oh, make sure you say goodbye to Mountain Rose for me, will you?
Don't worry about it. And listen, enjoy Mexico.
Thank you. Where do you think you're going?
Driving.
Yeah, Dad, it's done. Looks like they're going to be okay. What are you going to do?
Don't know why you insist on never putting bullets in the gun, but it was a good plan. Nice work, son. What a day.
Oh, never a dull moment. What's this? Admit it, you had fun, Martin. P.S. I owe you $300,000.
Whatever. I'm just glad he's gone.
Oh, me too. Me too. So, real husband, what do you say? Bed?
Race you upstairs.
On your mark, get set.
Hi.
Can we talk?
Absolutely. Come in.
I wanted to tell you something.
No. I know you do, but please. Me first, okay? But before, I didn't mean anything I said.
I get it.
No, you don't get it. I had a biker's gun to my head.
Really?
Yes, really. Plus, there was an axe.
Oh. I see.
Anyway, forget about all that. The point is, I had to get you out of here very quickly because he was going to kill you. And I had to say a lot of things. And the honest truth is, I didn't mean any of them.
Yeah, maybe you were right.
No. No, I am never right about anything.
Jake, we can't do this.
No, I guess we can't. I have a girlfriend, for God's sake. What am I saying?
She seems nice.
Yeah. Well, the mayor, you know, maybe he's not the spaz I thought he was, you know?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
This is gonna hurt.
Oh, why?
Give it up. Don't be a sook.